We have a CSV file with monthly detail of sales, expense, profitability, and customer count. We will create pivot tables from this data using Power Query and transform our data for yearly comparison. Then we will combine various pivot tables to form a single pivot table. Then we will use that table to create this dashboard of yearly comparative information. In Power BI Desktop, we will go to the Get Data menu and click on the CSV button. Then we will select the yearly sales CSV file and open it. Here, we normally press the Load button, which loads data into the Power BI. But today, we want to transform the data in Power Query Editor. In Power Query Editor, we will go to the Add Column tab and click on the Custom Column button. Here we can use the M query language to create a new column in our existing table. Let's call it Year. We will use the date.year function to get year from the date column. Be warned that the M language, unlike DAX, is case sensitive. A wrong case, such as D or Y in small, will cause an error. Here we will add reference to the date column. If your query is correct, and there is no apparent error, the warning below will turn to no error message. Now you can click on the OK button to add the custom column. We will add another column using the same custom column window. This time, we will get the month from the date column. We will use the date.month function and use the date column in the parameter. Then, just like before, we will click on the OK button to create the custom column. Now that we have all the columns we need, let's duplicate this table and rename it as Sales Pivot. We will remove all other columns from this table except the sales, year, and month columns. Now we will select the year column and go to the Transform tab and click on the Pivot Column button. In the Pivot Column window, we will select the Sales as Value column, and Sum as Aggregate function. This is it, this is the pivot table that we wanted. We have years as column headers, months as row headers, and sales as values. Now we need to create more pivot tables for expenses, profits, and customers. However, instead of creating each pivot table from scratch, we can use a shortcut. We can duplicate this pivot table and replace the sales column with one of the other columns. To do that, we will first duplicate this table and rename it to Expenses Pivot. Now we will go to the step where we removed the columns and we will replace the expenses with sales. Then we will apply the changes. Then we will go to the next step, which due to no sales column now, is now showing error. And here also, we will replace the sales column with the expenses column. And when we will apply the changes, we will end up with expenses in our pivot table instead of sales. Just like that, we will create a pivot table for profit column and another pivot table containing the number of customers. When we are done, we will go to the Home tab and click on the Close and Apply button. This will load all the tables to the Power BI Desktop application. The tables and their fields are available in the Data pane now. Before moving further, we will go to the Table view and change the data types of all month columns to numbers. If we don't change their data types, we will not be able to display our data in sequence. Because Power BI will sort those numbers as text, and will sort them wrong. Back to the report view, let's add a text box to our dashboard, and create a title. Let's add a visual border to our title. Now, we will add a line or area chart to our dashboard. And in the Y-axis, we will add all the year fields as sum, from sales pivot table. Then we will add the month field to the x-axis. And now we have the comparative yearly data of sales. However, this way we have to create each chart separately and from scratch. We can add an ID column to automate, organize, and simplify things here. To add the ID columns, we need to go to the query editor. Here we will add an ID column in each pivot table. And in the ID column, we will just enter the word identifying the table, such as sales. This way, we will add ID columns to all the pivot tables. After creating these ID columns, we will combine these tables together to form a single pivot table. We will select the first table, and in the Home tab, click on the Append Queries as New button. Here we will select three or more tables, and then add all pivot tables to the Append Query. Now, we will click OK to create a single table from these four tables. The ID column will now help us identify data, as all tables had same columns. Let's rename the Append table to Pivot. Now we can go back to Power BI and use this table in our report. Click on the Close and Apply button. This will add the table to the data pane. We will go to the data view and format the month column as numbers to properly display data in charts. Then we will format all the year columns using the comma button. Now we can only use the single pivot table to add all the information. Let's replace all the year columns in y-axis with years columns from pivot table. We will add the month field to the x-axis. This table now includes sales, expenses, profits, and customers. We can use filters to display each information. For example, let's add a slicer to our report and add the ID field from pivot to the slicer. Now, we can select each information, and the chart will display only the selected item. Let's place both visuals on our dashboard nicely. Now, let's duplicate the slicer and replace the ID field with the year field from yearly sales. Now, we can add a line and column chart for sales and profits visual. We will add the profit field to the line y-axis. We will add the sales field to the column y-axis. And the date field to the x-axis without month and day. We can duplicate this chart to add a similar chart with expenses instead of sales. We will just replace the sales field with the expenses field. Our dashboard of yearly comparison is now ready. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.